Welcome to Saturday Story Circle, always on the Mutual Audio Network.
The following audio drama is rated G for general audience.
Captain's log. We have just left Space Station Leaper, where we had to leave behind Dr. Bunny Hop and her assistant Mary Hoppet, as per Hare Command's orders, and are proceeding to...
Captain, we are receiving a new message from Hare Command. Captain.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant. I was distracted for a second. You know, sometimes I'm not sure where my mind is. What did you say?
Sir, we have received new orders from Hare Command. They want us to investigate some communications which they have intercepted from a planet at the outer edge of our patrol zone. From this information they have obtained, it appears to be from a new outpost for the Vulpedian Empire.
Lieutenant Ayres, inform Hare Command. Message received and will comply. Please give bearings to helm. Lieutenant Mazaka, as soon as you receive them, go to warp 3.
Yes, sir.
This is the adventure of the starship Jackalope. Our one-year mission to explore new garden patches on different worlds. To seek out larger and bigger carrots. To boldly go where no rabbit has gone before.
Star Rabbit Tracks. Featuring the voice talents of Alex Gilmore as Captain Peter Rabbit. Bobby Owens as Lieutenant Tanya Ears. Rocky Regano as Commander Thumper. David McIver as Lieutenant Teddy McZacker. Michael Liebman as Dr. Harvey Hopper Smith, Jules Ismail as Robot Alpha, and Stefana Littenbaum as Robot Delta.
Sir, our Lone Range sensors are picking up a small scout ship from the Vulpedian Empire in stable orbit around our destination planet.
Lieutenant Ayres, go to yellow alert.
Done, sir.
Commander, have they been able to pick us up?
I don't believe they had time, sir, as their ship was just beyond the horizon. To the foreside of the planet, when our sensors located them.
Good. Thank you, Commander. Mr. Mazaka, please keep that planet between us and their ship.
Aye, sir. Standard orbit. Impulse power.
Commander, were you able to identify that scout ship?
Yes, sir. Our data banks show that vessel to be a small Vulpian scout ship. Known as the Zulu Cub, with standard ornaments. It normally would have a crew of 6. Whatever they are doing here, they want to be as inconspicuous as possible. With that size ship, no one would know it was even there. If it wasn't for the communications coming from it, Captain... I don't know why, but my sensors are indicating that ship is made of a special metal, tin. I may need to recalibrate our instruments as soon as possible. They may have had some damage done from my last encounter with the Empire's ships.
You do that, Commander. I'm sure it's just a glitch from the last battle.
Sir, I have a call from sickbay. Dr. Hopper would like a word with you.
Acknowledged, Lieutenant. Please patch it here to my chair console. Captain here, Doctor. What can I do for you?
Captain, sorry to bother you. I need to finish my report about the anti-tick injections to Hare Command. Are you feeling any side effects?
I seem to be fine, Doctor. Are you having any problems?
No, I guess not. I guess I'm feeling a little nervous and felt a little insecure about the reactions.
Dr. Hopper, have a little courage. You're the best there is. I'm sure the feeling will pass, like most side effects. Captain, out.
Captain, we're being scanned from the planet below.
Commander, can you pinpoint the location of the scan and determine if it's the kind the Volpedian Empire uses?
Yes, sir. It seems to be originating from a modern city in the northern quadrant of this planet. It is not of the Empire's design, but it is coming from a well-populated city. It seems to have an emerald glow about it. Very strange. Very strange indeed.
Commander, go to Red Alert and...
Captain!
What?
Commander Bumper!
Commander! Captain! Lieutenant! Dr. Hopper! Dr. Hopper! Come in, sir! Are you there? Dr. Hopper, this is Lieutenant McZacker. Please respond. Computer, go Red Alert! Alpha, Delta, report! Is there anyone missing down there? Alpha, Delta, report! Let me do an internal search of personnel from the commander's console. I don't understand it. Alpha, Delta, the captain, commander, Lieutenant Ears, and Dr. Hopper are all gone, missing from the ship. Where in the rabbit holes could they have gone? Let me check the planet for rabbits. There they are, outside of the city, but I can't beam them back. Something's interfering with their transporters.
Commander,
Captain?
Everyone okay?
Sir, we seem to be standing outside of this very large green door.
Delta, are those poppy fields over there behind us? And a yellow brick road? Why would anyone want to make a yellow brick road? I mean, how would anyone see a yellow line down the middle?
They sure look and smell like poppies, Alpha. But how did we get here? The last thing I remember, I was fine-tuning my equations on how to increase the Jackalope's warp drive while repairing a module.
Captain, I feel we're not on the Jackalope anymore. My uniform has been replaced. I'm wearing a plaid jumper with a white blouse. Nice outfit, but not my style. And these shoes are clashing with my fur.
Commander, seems your uniform has been replaced with a tin suit.
Indeed, Captain. I do feel kind of stiff, and I noticed that your uniform is one that resembles an old-fashioned scarecrow. Out from a very old farm field.
Dr. Hopper, what is that behind you? That's not your tail. It's a lion's tail. Well, it seems you're the only one that has fur top to bottom.
You know, Captain, it does enhance the good doctor's appearance.
Commander, I can always say I had a heart.
At the present time, I think you're right, Doctor. I don't think I can feel one. Interesting, but extremely not logical.
Alpha, Delta, would you two please get off all fours?
Sorry, sir. I wish I could.
Captain, it seems for now it is impossible. We can only move around on all fours.
I don't understand what just happened or how we got here, and I'm sure not liking what we've become.
I have a bad feeling about this. Did I just say that?
Yep, definitely not my style.
All right, rabbits, focus.
Captain, I believe we are to ring the doorbell, since we are in front of this very large door. Doctor, would you like to have the honors?
No thanks, Commander. I don't have the courage. Nor do I want to know what's behind that door. It may scare me. You do it.
Well, as I say, if you want something done...
Who rang that bell?
I did.
Can't you read?
Read what?
Boy, some people. You would think you just popped in. The notice! It's on the door! It's as plain as the nose on my face!
We did just pop in, as you put it.
It's no excuse for not reading the notice. I mean, what is this world coming to? I mean, not to be able to read the notice. I forgot to put it out. Here!
What does the notice say, Captain?
Bell out of order. Please knock.
Very odd. For some reason, I can remember during my youth of reading or hearing something very similar to this situation. But it was so long ago that I can't recall much more.
Well, so much for your logical brain.
Doctor, did you say something?
No, not really. Just mentioned how great of a brain you have.
Why, thank you, Doctor.
Well, as I said earlier, if you want something done...
Oh my goodness, what a lovely place.
Oh my goodness, Lieutenant.
Sorry, sir. I feel like I'm playing a part. I don't understand it. Weird. I'm starting to like this outfit. And I think my name should be Dorothy. Am I Rabbit Ears Ribbons on right? And do you like my ruby red slippers? They're so shiny and pretty.
You know, I really should stop pulling on my tail. But it gives me such comfort to hold it.
Alpha, Delta, don't go beyond this door. Something is happening to the crew. I think. I'm not sure, though. Can't seem to think straight.
I do feel strange.
From this angle, you look strange.
Would someone tell me what is going on?
Wow! Bust my buttons! That's a horse of a different color! If you and your companions would follow me, I'm sure the wizard can explain everything.
I sure hope so, since our two robots are also affected.
Follow me!
Alpha, Delta, heal!
Alpha? Watch where you're swinging that!
I can't help it. I feel happy.
Who is it?
It is I! I have brought the group the wizard wants to see.
Orders are, nobody can see the Great Oz. Not nobody, not no how. Besides, he's dealing with a crisis now. Did you make an appointment?
No!
Go away and come back tomorrow.
The wizard wants to see them as soon as possible.
Well then, that does make a difference. Wait here and I'll announce you at once.
What's that in the sky?
Stop scratching yourself. And it looks like a fox in a black witch's outfit on a broomstick. I wonder how she does that.
She's riding something in the sky with that broom. Surrender, Dorothy!
Surrender what?
I don't know, but I am picking up some strange power source radiating from your red slippers.
They do feel a little tingling, but I've gotten used to it. I thought maybe they were a size too small.
Lieutenant Ears, I mean Dorothy, do you feel all right?
Yes, Tin Man. I feel just fine otherwise.
You stay close by, and I'll protect you with my axe.
What axe?
Interesting. I feel like I should have an axe. Well, never mind. I'll still will protect you.
Oh, come on. I can hardly think with what is all going on. Where is that guard? I can feel something crawling up my leg. I hope it's not a field mouse.
The wizard is waiting for you. Your dogs can stay out here.
I was just thinking, maybe I should wait outside with our dogs.
Come on, Lion. Show some courage and stop pulling your tail. You're going to move all the hair.
Dorothy, the small and meek, and this is the Scarecrow and...
Silence! The great and powerful Oz knows why you have come. I brought you here.
Why?
Why? Why? Because I need your help. 2 months ago, a wicked creature came from outside our world. From the west, dressed as a witch. She has been stealing what technology we have and has been looking for a very small but mighty power source. We almost lost that power. Then you showed up. Those slippers contain that power source she seeks. She has discovered what we have done and is after those ruby red slippers.
What if I just gave her these slippers? She would leave, and you would all
no,
be
grand. You don't understand. If we gave her what she wants, she will use it to destroy our way of life. She wants to turn us all into slaves, as she has done to the people of the West. You must protect that power at all costs. When your ship approached my planet, I was able to scan your records and found you have combated this creature before. I did note that there were winners and losers on both sides of your confrontation. I have brought you all down here dressed as you are and changed your personalities a little so as not to frighten my people. You need to help us by getting rid of that witch by any means possible. And protect our power source.
Why should we help you? You kidnapped me and my crew. I think.
What you say is true. I did bring you here. But we are a desperate race, through no fault of our own. We will not stand a chance if you do not help. I will reward you handsomely if you will get rid of that witch. However, if you fail, and we are enslaved, my last act will be to bring all your crew down here to be slaves. Do you understand what I mean?
Why haven't you brought their crew down here? I wonder where that thought came from.
The broom that the witch rides has a device in it that prevents me from doing so. Bring me that broom! If you succeed, I will return you and your crew back to the ship. As they were before.
Sir, I don't think we have much of a choice.
Scarecrow, we must help these people. Please.
Can we go? My hair is rising up my back. My legs want me out of here. And my tail is losing its hair.
Now go and bring me that broom. has taken control of an old stone castle to the west and enslaved the peasants to act as your guards. Now I said go!
I'm out of here. Feet, don't fail me now. Get me out of here. Let me go. No, get me out of here.
What are those signs ahead?
Oh, you mean the one that says Haunted Forest, which is Castle 1 mile. Or the other one that says, I turn back if I were you.
Whoa! Yes, those are the ones. Sometimes I wonder about your upgrade.
I don't like this. I've changed my mind. I want to go back.
Oh, no, you don't.
But it's scary here.
Come on, let's stay together. I think it would be safer. I think.
I can see you, my pretties, in my viewfinder. Guards! Take a few more men and bring me back that girl with one of her dogs. Do what you like with the others, but I want her alive and unharmed. They'll give you no problems.
Yes, your evilness.
Now go, and make sure you bring me those slippers. Go! Go!
Second Master, I have just received a message from Headmaster.
Proceed, Fox Trekker.
Second Master, Headmaster reported that the rabbit ship Jackalope is in orbit on the far side of this world, and that some of her crew is on the planet.
Has she been found out? Do we need to pull her out?
No, Second Master. However, she does say that she has everything under control, and that she wants us not to interfere. Something about playing with the rabbits.
I hope she knows what she is doing. Did she say anything about retrieving the power source?
Nothing more than she hopes to have it soon, Second Master.
If we can get that, we will have the power for the new Caratinian warp drives. Once it's completed, we will be able to catch our fast foes. They will have no place to hide. I wonder if we should seek out the Jackalope.
Second Master, Headmaster did say to do nothing. Besides, we would be no match against her.
True. Well, if something goes wrong, we can always say that we did obey her orders.
Yes, Second Master, we could.
Tracker, make sure all sensors are on the horizons of this planet. If their ship comes out of hiding, be prepared to leave orbit at once.
What about the Headmaster?
We will deal with that when the time comes.
Yes, Second Master, as you command.
This is the great and powerful Oz.
Who? What?
Silence, rabbits, and hear my words. Your fellow crewmates are here on this planet.
Well, so much for keeping that from the rest of the ship. I don't suppose you could just talk to me by some chance?
What is it with you rabbits? Oh, all right, as you wish. Your fellow crewmates are on this planet.
Yes, I already know that.
Silence, Helms officer, let me finish. They have a mission to complete.
And if they succeed, they will be returned. If not, all of you will join them.
What kind of mission? And what do you mean by joining them?
We of the Emerald City did not know of such evil as the creatures from the Vulpedian Empire. By the time I found out, it was too late. They also have a device that blocks some of my power to use against them, but you do not.
So much for being all powerful.
If your Captain Peter Rabbit and crew don't succeed, you will know of my power. You are helpless. They must complete this mission on their own. Time will tell all. The small ship of foxes on the other side of my planet knows of your existence. However, I am sure you will not have to worry about them this time.
So what you want me to do is just hang around up here and do nothing?
I believe you have no choice but to await the outcome.
Just great. I get to be acting captain aboard this wonderful ship, and I'm told to do nothing.
Precisely, helmsman.
I wonder how I'm going to say this in the captain's log. Let's see. Helms officer in temporary control of the mighty USS Jackalope was told by some weird voice that calls himself Oz over the ship's speaker to sit. What next? Luke Skywalker and R2-D2. Feel the force, McZacker.
Silence! Time will tell.
Can I at least see them? Hello, you there? Oz? Lou? This has got to be the mother of all rabbit holes.
Soldiers! Run! Run!
Run? Like this? I can barely walk on all fours!
Quick! Everyone hide!
I'm afraid it's already too late. We are surrounded.
Try not to hurt them. They're under the witches. I mean foxes control.
Hurt them? I'm worried about them hurting me! Ouch! My tail! Somebody pull my tail!
Lion! If you would let your tail go, it won't hurt as much.
Take that! Ha!
Help!
Ow!
Help!
Ow!
Help! 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 Help!
Help!
Help!
Oh no! They're carrying away Dorothy! I mean Lieutenant Ayres! And Delta!
Yes, Scarecrow. I mean, Captain. But we are holding the other guards back. Get away from me.
They're pulling back. Where's the doctor? I mean the lion. I mean, I don't know what I mean.
What?
The rabbit with the long tail.
I'm stuffed in the hollowed-out log. Help!
I guess we better get Dr. Hopper out. Sure wish I had that axe.
What, to split the log? You could hurt the good doctor.
True. Sure wish I had that axe. Just pulling your straw, Captain. Here, let me help you get him out.
Thank goodness you got me out. I was beginning to feel like a burrito in there. And, Commander, we need to talk about your ex problem. I know of a good psychologist.
I was also going to recommend one about your tail fetish, my good doctor.
All right, let's get together. We've got to find Lieutenant Ayres. Alpha, do you have a fix on Delta?
Yes, sir. They went this way.
Oh.
What a nice little robot. And you, my dear. What a time to visit me in my loneliness.
What are you going to do with my dog? I mean, Delta, release her.
All in good time, my pretty. All in good time. When you give me those slippers.
But the great wizard told me not to.
Guards, throw that robot from the highest castle wall. That should make tiny little pieces of her precious robot.
No, no, no. You can have your old slippers. But release Delta. She's done nothing.
That's a fine rabbit. I knew you would see reason. Here, let me help you take them off. Why, you! My nails! My nails! My beautiful sharp nails! You will pay for this!
Can I have my dog back now?
No! I should have realized that there was some kind of force field on them. Those slippers will never come off as long as you're alive. But that's not what is worrying me. It's how to do it. These things must be done delicately, or they could destroy us all.
Go, Delta, go! Run! Get away!
You're lucky your robot got away. Never seen a robot move so fast. However, that's more than I can say about you. It will soon be over now. You see this hourglass? That is how much time you have left to be alive. It isn't long, my pretty. It isn't long. Can't wait forever to get that power. I will be back after the poisonous gas has been released and done its job. When the air has been cleaned out.
I'm frightened. Captain, where are you?
Captain, where are you? Lieutenant, they won't make it in time.
Captain, where are you?
There's Doctor.
There you are.
Yes, my sensors were set on your wavelength.
Hurry! We must hurry! Lieutenant Ears is in trouble! We must climb that mountain, and don't ask me how I got down from there. I had to use just my hands.
My strength holds out from climbing this mountain. Hey, take it easy on my tail.
Strength. I hope your tail holds out. What a climb. I knew I would find this handy.
Shh. We're at the top. There's the castle. And the drawbridge.
Indeed, Captain. Look at the expression of the guards. It is that they are in a trance.
Look, more guards. I think they're changing shifts.
I've got a plan on how to get inside.
You got a plan?
And you're going to lead us.
I'm going to do what? You're the captain. You should go first. All right. For Dorothy. Foxes or no foxes. Guards or no guards. I'll tear them apart. Oof. I may not come out alive, but I'm going in there. There's only one thing I want you rabbits to do.
What's that?
Talk me out of it.
Oh, no, you don't. Let's get down there.
Oof.
Shh.
Oof.
Do you feel something poking from behind?
Oh no! There were three guards at our backs!
Take that! Quick, I have an idea. Since we're able to wear these guards' uniforms and they are tied up, let's...
Do you think it would be polite to go in, dressed as this?
Come on, follow me. We're going to join the group of guards going back inside the castle.
Inside. Let's hide up against this wall.
Where do we go now, Captain?
This way! Quickly!
Don't you just love those wolves?
Alpha, shh! Follow Delta up the stairs to that door.
In here! In here!
Dorothy, are you there? I mean, Lieutenant Ears, are you there?
Yes, it's me. Sharptooth locked me in.
Sharptooth!
Hurry, please, hurry! The poisonous gas is about to be released.
Stand back. I'll use the battle axe. I was able to get off the guard. I knew I was to have an axe.
You're all right. Quick! We must leave. The gas is about to be released.
Everyone, to the front door.
I'll never be able to chop that open.
Going so soon, Captain Peter Rabbit. I won't hear of it. Why, my little get-together is just beginning! Guards, surround them!
Trapped, like mice, rats!
Quick, Commander, cut that rope. It will drop the chandelier on the guards.
Stop them, you fools! Stop them! Get after them! They're trying to get away! Quick, they're headed up to the castle walls. Half of you go this way. The others with me. Hurry!
Hurry, this way. Let's get to the other side.
Sir, they're coming from both sides.
We're trapped. Nowhere to go.
Well, ring around the rosy, a pocket full of spears. Thought you could outfox me, didn't you? The last to go, we'll see all go before her.
Commander, quick, give me your axe.
Sure, here.
What have you done? What have you done? You broke my hold on these guards by destroying my mind-controlling broom! No! No! Look what you have done! I have to get away! Beam me up now! Beam me up now! I failed! What a world! What a world! What a world!
She's gone. You've killed her.
No, she's not dead, just misplaced.
Hail to Dorothy! Hail to Dorothy! The Wicked Witch is gone!
Hail Dorothy! Hail Dorothy!
Dear sir, may we have the two halves of the broom?
Here, please take it.
You freed us all.
All right, crew. Back to the wizard.
Get us out of here, Second Master!
But, Headmaster, what about the power source?
Never mind about the power source! I was lucky enough to get out with my life!
Lord Volpez will not be pleased.
Enough. I will handle Lord Volpez.
Tracker, leave orbit.
Heading, Second Master.
Back to Volpedia.
Belay that order, Tracker.
Headmaster.
I need time to think. Take us to just outside Volpedian space.
As you wish, Headmaster. At what speed?
Warp 1!
As you wish, Headmaster.
Do not disturb me. I will be in my chambers.
Tracker, proceed.
I don't believe my eyes. You have made it back.
Please, sir. We've done what you wanted. We brought you the broomstick from that evil creature. Of course, it's in two pieces and not repairable.
So, you got rid of her. Very resourceful.
So, we would like you to keep your promise.
Not so fast, not so fast. I have to give this matter a little thought.
We have fulfilled your mission. Now, return us to our ship.
Go away and come back tomorrow.
Fulfill your side of the bargain.
I said, come back tomorrow. And get that robot away from those curtains.
Come over here.
Captain, look what the robots have uncovered.
Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. The great and powerful Oz has spoken.
Who are you?
I am the great. I am
the Wizard of Oz.
You are? I don't believe you.
I'm afraid it's true. There's no other wizard than me.
You humbug.
Yes, it's true I'm a humbug. I had no other choice. I had to do it for my people.
You could have asked.
There wasn't enough time. That captain of the Fox's ship almost got her hands on that power source.
How about releasing us?
Once that broom was broken, her power over me is gone. You can go back at any time.
What about the offer you made us?
My dear rabbits, you have all honored us with your bravery. We do not have much, but our world is open to your civilization as a vocation world. To come here as often as your race wishes. Of course, you'd have to wear different clothes to blend in with our culture.
You know, Captain, our crew and others that come out this far could use a safe place to put our tails up and relax.
What tail?
Captain, you know what I mean.
Sir, it would be a logical choice. I'm sure the good doctor could use this place, since he seems to have picked up a bad habit.
Bad habit?
Yes, doctor. Pulling one's tail.
Commander, that was involuntary. Part of that character's habits, not mine.
Interesting. I think you can let go of your tail now.
What? Yes, I guess I could. Be glad when we get back to the ship.
Captain, now that we know what kind of ship to look out for, we can keep the Fox Nation out. With our power source safely back, things are running at 100%.
Sir, we thank you for your offer. We shall contact Hair Command and let them know of your generous suggestion. Please, next time, ask for our help.
Thank you, Captain. I would like to add a few more thoughts, if I may. Dr. Hopper, you have shown a lot of courage when it was really needed the most. Commander, even if you don't want to show a lot of emotion, you express a lot of heart. During your mission, Captain, your leadership showed you have far more superior brains than ever you thought. Lieutenant Tanya Ears, You were the center of everyone's thoughts. You showed caring and understanding, even to the robots, a very admirable trait. And last, Alpha and Delta, two of the most devoted robots I've ever seen. I wish I had two such as them. But now, I must bid you all a safe farewell.
Wizard, sir? Can I talk to you for just a moment?
Yes, Delta. What is it?
I would like to ask...
I wish the captain was...
You called, Lieutenant.
Captain! Lieutenant Ears! And Commander! Welcome back! Am I glad you're all back? This voice named Oz said...
We know, Lieutenant. No need to go any further.
It's nice to see you, too. And I'm glad to be back in my uniform.
Huh?
Never mind, Lieutenant. You can listen as I give my report to Hare Command.
Thank you, Captain. I can hardly wait.
Dr. Hopper?
Yes, Captain?
How's your tail?
Back at being a great looking bushy tail, sir.
You don't have to rub it in, my good doctor. Captain, out. Bridge to engineering.
Yes, Captain?
Is everything all right there?
Yes, sir. All accounted for and ready for departure.
Thank you, Alfred. Hell. Anything on the Vulpedian ship?
Sir, they left orbit about an hour ago. It seems like they left with their tails between their legs, since they left kind of slow.
I bet. I'm sure we'll be seeing them again. Helm, set a course for 133.8. Warp factor 3.
Aye, sir. 133 Mark 8 set in. Warp factor 3.
Boy, do I have a long report to make to Hare Command. Activate.
Sure am glad I'm not a dog anymore.
Alpha, quit scratching yourself.
Featured in the cast were Alex Gilmore as Captain Peter Rabbit, Bobby Owens as Lieutenant Tanya Ears, Rocky Regano as Commander Thumper, David MacIver as Lieutenant Teddy McZacker, Michael Liebman as Dr. Harvey Hopper Smith, Jules Ismail as Robot Alpha, and Stefana Littenbaum as Robot Delta. Our special guests were Melissa Danielle Johnson as Fox Headmaster Sharptooth, Kim Giannopoulos as Fox Tracker, Abner Cenaris as Fox Second Master, James W. Smagata as the Wizard of Oz, Captain John Tatterzak as the guard at the door, Tim Bartzik as the guard number 2 inside the palace, and David Grizzly Smith as guard number 3 inside the witch's castle. Star Rabbit Tracks Over the Rainbow was written and produced by Captain John Tatterzak, edited by Miles Liptak, post-production by James W. Smagata. Our webmaster is April Sadowski, and our art director is Alexa Chipman. Captain John Tatterzak is the CEO of MisfitsAudio.com. We would like to confirm that no harm came to any rabbits, robots, ships, foxes, or guards while producing this audio. We are not affiliated in any way with Star Trek, Beatrix Potter, or The Wizard of Oz, written by Frank L. Baum, the classic motion picture owned by Turner Entertainment Company and distributed in all media by Warner Brothers. This production is for enjoyment purposes only. We hope you have enjoyed this audio. I am your announcer, MJ Cogburn, for Misfits Audio 2009.
Yes, Delta, what is it?